A/B testing in Swift UI can become incredibly easy with Qonversion, allowing you to instantly test different UI elements, features, or pricing strategies without the need for updates. Why I like this platform is because on top of the full in-app purchase infrastructure, you get monetization tools, so you actually make money with your app and know what works best for your users. The thing is, A/B testing is very complex to implement if you do it on your own. It's like juggling multiple tools, one for subscription management, another for analytics, another for setting up test groups. That's why not many app developers use A/B testing. But today, I'm going to show you how to set up A/B testing so you can see how easy it is and how to do it too. This is the second part of a two-part series about remote conflicts / experiments with Qonversion. So if you haven't already done so, please take a look at the description for the playlist and take a look at the previous one, because we have set up remote config. It's really important for experiments in Qonversion. Okay, so currently we have one remote config. It's going to, it's giving us an info, whether it's Qonversion or Rebeloper, whatever we have set it up currently is hello Rebeloper. So the info is Rebeloper. And there we go. Here we have our text. A default value, if we don't get anything, it's just going to be defaulting to world. Okay, so this is what we have. And let me just take you back to the configuration. So here we have, let's just start remote config, and then remote config, we have our main framework configuration. And what we have here is an info Rebeloper. We may edit this if we choose to, the Qonversion. That's what I did at the end of my previous video in the series. Now, I don't want to switch between Qonversion and Rebeloper for the info. What I actually want to do is test it out, which one works better for my users. Therefore, we are going to create an experiment. So what we are going to do is just go back all the way to your active remote config and click on these three dots right over here and select create experiment. Okay, experiment main, experiment for main paywall, that's fine. Context key main paywall. You should leave it as is because we already have set this up to grab it as main underscore paywall as the remote config. So that's fine. What is my hypothesis? So something like that, whatever you see fit for your change. Okay, let's continue. And again, this is your hypothesis. Choose primary metric. The metric, there are plenty, user to try Qonversion, new trials. Just go through all of these. Mine currently is just sales. So what is the direction? I will have an increase and then 20% increase in sales. So I believe that sales metric will increase by at least 20%. Okay. That's our plan. That's what we are experimenting with. Now, we want to configure this. So you see, the control group has been already added for from our remote config, what we have set up. That's great. We may add a new variant if we choose to, but most probably you have a lot of these key value pairs. What I suggest is just going right over here, clicking on the three dots and selecting make a copy. And that will make a copy of the control group. Now, because I have just one, I would just change this to Qonversion. And then let's just save this. And there we go. Control group copy. This is the version of our experiment. You may edit these if you choose to, or you may also add, and you should add a rule. Now you can have, the rules are basically who should get this or when it should be added. Active subscription, app install date, app version. Go ahead and check all of these out. Currently, because this is a tutorial, I want it to be instant, so I'm not going to set anything right over here. But what you should definitely set also, and I'm not going to do this because again, this is just a tutorial, is the traffic allocation. So you don't want to bombard all of your users with this experiment. You should choose a lower percentage than 100. So let's say you just say 20 or, you know, 10%. I'm just going to go again 100 because I do want to show you that the experiment is coming in into my application, but you should definitely start really low. So, you know, it's not going to go to all of your users. Maybe this experiment will not be a good idea. So only 10% of your users will be exposed to it. Okay. So that's our setup. Now what we want to do is just, let's go back to Xcode. And if I build and run again, actually nothing will be different. So it says, hello, Rebeloper. The difference here is that now the Rebeloper info, for the key info, is actually the group right over here, the control group. It's not the copy of the control. So it's A, always a control group. Now, okay, but I get Rebeloper, and if you build and run, sometimes you will get also Qonversion. I want to test this out really well. How will it look with Qonversion? I had a typo over here, so let me just, Qonversion, there we go. I want this B to be present in my app. So in order to do that, we need to attach this experiment, well, actually the group, to our user. And we're going to need two keys, the experiment key right over here and the group key. But first, let me just type out the code for you. Let's go to our Xcode project. And then in the app delegate, remember we grab the remote config right over here. Before we even grab the remote config, we need to attach a user. And that is done with Qonversion.shared. Share, there we go. Dot attach user to remote config. No, we are going to attach to experiment with a group ID, and I also need a completion so I know what just happened. So let's just use this one to experiment. That's a string, and I'm going to go back, and this is the experiment key basically. Let's just add it right over here, and then the group ID. The group ID are these. These two. Of course, now I just want not the control, I just want this one with a Qonversion. Let's copy that and add it right over there. Under completion, we are going to get back a success boolean and also an optional error. Let's take care of the error first. If let error, then it's not error fetching remote config, but MO error fetching. Error attaching user, and then if success, then user attached to experiment, else let's just print out user not attached to experiment. Okay, or do whatever you'd like in these cases. Okay, so now let's build and run and let's see what happens. In some cases, the very first run will actually not attach it fast enough. But as you can see, most of the times, it's just going to get it. And now we have hello Qonversion, which is really, really great. Now, what if you want to add another one? So you want to attach the user to another experiment. It's not that simple to just attach it to, you know, just change the two experiment and the group ID. If you want to change the group ID, that's fine. But a two experiment, you don't just change it. First, you need to detach it. So let me just comment this out and then add Qonversion dot shared, there we go, dot detach user from experiment with a completion, and this is the experiment, this is the experiment key, there we go, pasting it in there, and then we are going to get back a success, and then optional error, and then, yeah, let me just copy all of this out and do the necessary changes. So if we have an error detaching a user detached from experiment and user not detached from experiment. So First, we need to detach our user. Let's see, success with two S's. I just had a typo right over there. So let's build and run if success, another typo. There we go. Finally found it. So now we should see user detached from experiment. And of course, it's just going to give us back the control, the Rebeloper right over here. That's it. It was pretty easy to set up this test. I hope next time you decide to change something in your app, you remember this video and test it first to see how it affects your conversions or revenue. Hope you liked the video and have fun with A/B testing.